Okay, thank you so much for being part of this interview. The people of Santa Cruz are very excited to have the Gipsy Kings coming to town. Yes, and by way of introduction, in case people do not know you, but they probably do, Tonino Baliardo is the leader and founder of the Gipsy Kings. They have sold over 20 million albums worldwide. They have four Grammy nominations to their name and one Grammy Award in 2014 for the best global music album. They have toured all over the world in major concert halls, and they had a very humble beginning, which I'd like to ask you about. Tell me about your childhood and how maybe did you think you would ever be touring the world when you were a little kid?
Peut-être un peu parce que bon, j'ai commencé très jeune à faire de la musique et on faisait jouer à des restaurants, tout ça en Camargue, qui est un peu dans la région, avec des plus âgés que moi.
So Tonino started at a very young age, playing with older family members, and then he started to play in local clubs and bars, and he always had that drive. He always wanted to, and felt like something was going to happen, where he would eventually make it on a global scale. And one day when he got married, he told his wife, "I think this music thing will take me somewhere, and I think it's going to work, and it's going to pay for everything for us, and it's going to be wonderful." And so yes, it seems like he kind of felt it before it even happened.
And tell me about the connection between the name, the Gypsy Kings, and your personal family heritage as someone who's a gitano.
Ben oui, parce qu'il y avait, ouais, de famille, il y avait les Ries, ils avaient joué comme moi aussi en Camargue et tout ça, c'était des petits groupes de los Ries. Et puis moi, de mon côté, et puis on s'est associés, genre, on discutait pour faire monter un groupe. Hein. Et à partir de là, ça s'est appelé. Et puis,
Tonino's grandparents were from the Barcelona, Catalonia area. And then his grandparents moved to to France with his parents, and he kept that heritage. And Tonino is from the family of Manita de Platas, who's like a legendary guitar player. And when he met with the Reyes family, who was making some, doing some music in the same area back then, they decided to create a group with the best of both worlds, singers and guitars. And so when they were thinking about a name for a group, many names came across, and the one that stuck was Gypsy King.
And the name Gypsy, ha in this country, people aren't sure whether it's okay to use that word anymore. Some people find it to be offensive now, but it didn't used to be. Can you talk about the name and whether using it is controversial in other parts of the world, other than the United States?
Oui, parce que voilà, en fait, voilà, on a l'image aussi voilà, des gitans qui n'étaient pas vraiment intégrés et tout ça, c'est une longue histoire aussi. Mais nous, voilà, c'est un peu vrai tout ça, mais nous, gypsies, on est gitans, quoi. Et on a profité pour utiliser ce nom, pour montrer justement qu'on est gitan et qu'on fait.
I mean, in France, it's about the same, same thing happening. Part of the gypsies are not really don't really want to integrate with the rest of the population, and it's that part that kind of causes problem with the rest of the population. But Tonino is a proud gypsy, and he's from those who like to share with others, and get integrated into a bigger picture, so he where he understands where it's coming from, he's still very proud of being a gypsy, and and don't think he doesn't think it should be, you know, seen as something negative.
Thank you so much for that response. I want to talk about what it's like to tour with your family members now that you have two sons in the band and a cousin. How is that for you?
Ah ben, oui, je suis très fier déjà que j'ai mes deux fils avec moi, Kosso et Michael, et des talents de la communauté aussi qui sont de par chez nous. Mais ouais, je retrouve une nouvelle énergie.
Well, yeah, obviously, Tonino is very, very proud, you know, to have his sons on stage playing with him. And, you know, they bring such, you know, energy to the stage, fresh energy, you know, and it makes a difference, you know, to him, because he's been playing with, you know, the other group members for so long now, having, you know, younger people, and especially his sons. Playing alongside with him on stage, you know, it's a shift in terms of energy, and obviously he's very proud.
I was wondering if you can talk about how appearing in the Big Lebowski, in that amazing scene with John Turturro where he is El Diablo and playing that song, Hotel California, how did that change your fame or your popularity after that movie?
Mais oui, mais c'est, en fait, c'était un succès pour le film, mais pour nous aussi, parce que la chanson, elle a marché, en fait, même encore, on la joue sur scène.
Well, yes, it definitely had a significant impact on their career until this day, because they're still playing it on stage, you know, and people really, really love it. So, Tonino is very grateful for this opportunity. Again, he's proud, you know, of having been a part of such an iconic movie, because, you know, like it is an iconic movie.
Por el camino del desierto, el viento me despeina, sueva aroma de colita, una dona del aire, ella de lo lejos. Una luz en tela, la idea de mezcal, te vi por en la noche, ella estaba a la entrada y la campana de sonar, y me dijo ya mi mimo, de topo del cielo, ella enciende una vela y nuestra de camino, soy moza el corriador y yo te dije diciendo, welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place, such a lovely place. Welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place, such a lovely Somos todos prisioneros, por propia voluntad, y a los cuatro principales hacen su siesta, atacan a la bestia, pero no la logra matar. Mi último recuerdo, corriacen de la puerta, debió encontrar el camino por donde había llegado, en la Gracias, rico portero, con eso no recibí. Puedes salir cuando quieres, pero nunca de partir. Welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place. Such a lovely place. Welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place. Such a lovely place.
And you were in Toy Story as well, the Toy Story 3. That must have also been a big boost because so many children watched that movie.
Beh, oui, bah, ça, oui, oui, c'est fait, c'est une demande de Pixar. Moi qui voulais Gipsy King, et ça s'est bien passé. Nous étions à Londres enregistré justement.
Yeah, so they've been contacted by Pixar, who really wanted the Gipsy Kings for this scene. For this song, and so they went to London to record, and it was very, very agreeable to record and work with the Pixar teams there. So yes, and it definitely another boost for their career for sure.
Cuando salgan a volar, hay un amigo en mí. Sí, un amigo en mí. Hay un amigo en mí. Hay un amigo en mí. Hay un amigo en mí. Cuando salgan a volar, hay un amigo en mí. Sí, un amigo en mí.
You have some major hits. You have Bambaleo, Jobi Joba, Un Amor, Volare. Do you ever get tired of playing these amazing, beautiful songs, or do you bring a fresh idea every time you perform them?
Non, c'est peut-être étonnant, mais c'est vrai que ça fait des années qu'on les joue. Eh bien, toujours, on les joue avec le même enthousiasme et la même envie de jouer ça, parce qu'on voit que le public est...
You know, after now nearly 40 years playing the same songs, seeing the crowd enjoying those songs, you know, as much as they do each time, you know, gives him that energy to keep on performing them and actually enjoying So no, he's never getting bored
No tiene la culpa. caballo le dan tabana, porque muy despreciado, por eso no te perdono llorar. Ese amor llega así, esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Amor de compraventa, amor del pasado. Ven, 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 ven. Bambolea, bambolea, porque mi vida yo la prefiero vivir así. Bambolea, bambolea, porque mi vida.
And a typical Gipsy Kings concert involves a lot of dancing because you play rumbas, you play flamenco, all kinds of styles, salsa. Talk about the audience and what you've seen over the years. I saw somebody jump on the stage one time. They had to be escorted off. So what's the experience of the audience and the band interacting for you?
Non, non, mais bien sûr, mais ça fait partie de notre carrière, du mouvement, quoi. Beaucoup de gens ont monté sur scène pour danser avec nous. Beaucoup de jolies filles, des personnes, ils sont montés sur scène et...
So yes, you know, obviously it's always a big what they call it, a big fiesta, and they love, particularly Tonino loves to have, you know, people on stage. Sometimes people just jump on stage without being invited, you know. But this it's still great for Tonino, because he feels like it's part of his, you know, his job, if I might call it even a job. And it's always happened like this, where on the last songs, they enjoy, you know, pull some people on stage. Sometimes there were like 25 to 40 people on stage and dancing, you know. Some can dance, some can't, but it doesn't really matter. It's the energy, you know, that counts, that matters. So it's always great to see the interaction, and they always tend to encourage having people on stage.
I want to talk about guitars, because I know as a guitar player, you care a lot about what you play. Tell me about the different guitars you play on stage and about the Gibson, which is unusual for flamenco guitar.
Ça a été un problème pour moi au début, parce que bon, j'avais l'habitude de jouer avec des flamenco sur les albums et tout, une guitare flamenco acoustique. Mais pour avoir, parce qu'on faisait des salles énormes en fait, il fallait la puissance du son et commencer avec des...
Yes, so Tonino started with acoustic guitars, you know, because, I mean, it was enough back then to play on albums and to play for little clubs. But then quickly, when things escalated and they started to, you know, to play arenas, he needed, well, you know, he went into a big problem, which was the guitars were not powerful enough. And the power was, you know, very, very important, and still is to this day for Tonino. So he's been looking for a couple of years to find the right guitar. And luckily enough, you know, he came across the Gibson, which was an electroacoustic guitar and was super powerful and sounded very, very good, you know. And so it allowed him to express his art in, you know, the easiest and most reliable manner.
So to follow up on that, at any given time, sometimes there's four guitars on stage. How do you decide who gets to play when? How do you arrange that many guitars in a piece of music?
C'est des guitares d'accompagnement que les chanteurs jouent aussi. Ils chantent et jouent le matin, mais on est cinq guitares.
Yes, so basically, you know, Tonino is the lead guitar, and there's five guitars total. So it's Tonino's and as an electroacoustic guitar, and then four acoustic guitars. And they're basically accompanying him, you know. It's more of accompanying, you know, the main guitar than anything else.
Well, is there anything you would like to say to the residents of Santa Cruz, to the KSQD listeners, in anticipation of your May 19th performance at the Warrior Stadium?
Ben, j'aimerais dire que nous, déjà, on est ravis de jouer à Santa Cruz. Et voilà, nous, on joue le cœur qu'on a, avec la passion qu'on a, avec nos guitares et nos voix. Et très heureux de faire la fête avec eux, des émotions et de faire une belle soirée pour eux.
They're all very excited and looking forward to be there, you know, with their friends for a big fiesta. They will come with their heart, you know, and with their passion, and they hope everyone will enjoy as always.
We are very excited to hear you and see you, and thank you for your time today. I really appreciate you taking the moment to talk to our listeners.
Thank you, Rachel.
You've been listening to an interview with Tonino Baliardo of the Gipsy Kings, the founding member and lead guitarist. The Gipsy Kings with Tonino Baliardo will appear at the Warrior Stadium May 19th in the city of Santa Cruz. I'm Rachel Ann Goodman. Thanks for listening.